Let's talk about how to choose the perfect CRM system for your business. And CRM is really the heartbeat of your business, but if you make the wrong choice, it can take a long time to unwind. Not only is the wrong choice in CRM system going to hold back your team from getting great results because you may have an inefficient system or slower way of doing something, or balls might be dropped in your actual execution of the business, but it's a big, expensive, time-consuming project to change technology systems. And so a CRM system is the kind of thing that you put in and you don't really get to take out for 3 or 5 or even more years unless you've got a bloody good reason, because they kind of become like a database with a central source of information, and you want to make sure that that doesn't have to be transposed to a new system 18 months down the line because you've made the wrong choice. Now, why is it important to have a CRM system in your business? Well, you want to make sure that you have a system to manage your deal flow, manage email broadcasts, your interactions between you and your customers. Really, it's about getting the right results for your business. And getting the right results means that we're getting the objectives met of our business with our team without us having to manually chase them and follow them up ourselves. And so it's a way of getting things done in your way or the business's way without you having to be the police to make sure that everything works. And how do I know that? Well, I know that for me, I work 3 days a week and I take 4 day weekends because I've got great technology systems that support our team. And of course, people come into it and process comes into it as well. Technology driven business strategy is something that we've relied heavily on for our business success. And it brings me a lot of freedom in my life. And that's why I'm here. I'm basically in semi-retired mode now. I could do nothing and our team would just continue to grow and the business would continue to pay me and all would be good. But I really enjoy helping to grow other small businesses, and I really enjoy supporting our community of small business owners to get more out of their business. So let's talk about 3 different focus areas of CRM software, because I want to kind of give you like a meta awareness and a broad understanding of different kinds of CRM software so you are equipped to make key decisions on what kind of software that you need. First type of software is focused on deal management. That's the kind of software that is really focused on the flow of you managing deals. This is really ideally for a sales team. This is really about making sure that you and your sales team have what's needed. Now, think about like Pipe Drive is one of those that's really managed, focused on the different stages of a deal. Our CRM has a great deal flow management as well. Some of the ones that live inside of Gmail, like Streak, also really focused on flowing deals through different stages. Next up is one that's focused on workflow management. And so this is more of a customer database that happens to have some workflow management type tools as well. So the kind of things that I think about here are like Podio. You could kind of count tools like Asana or Monday.com in this basket as well, where it's kind of about what are the tasks that need to be done broadly across the business, and are there different automations or tasks that pop up as something goes through different stages. That's more the workflow management side of things. If it includes a customer database, if it includes customer records, then it's still technically in the CRM arena. Now, the third one is mail automation. And so these are CRM systems that are focused on email automation. So think about Entreport, HubSpot, Infusionsoft. These are ones that have really sophisticated email campaign automation. And these ones are really primarily focused on communicating to your customers. And some of them also have sales and checkout and transaction modules as well for you to be able to do business online. So it might be selling online courses or membership websites, or you just have particularly sophisticated customer journeys that you want to have in email campaigns, and you want to have a lot of automation based on that. That gives you an idea of kind of like the 3 different areas of CRM systems. And based on the business that you're in, you would choose to use different areas. So for example, if you are a consulting firm and you have a low number of new leads that come through, but you have a number of existing clients that you want to really deliver a lot of services to, you'd probably more likely be looking at something that's more workflow focused, because you're looking at delivering something to your customers. And something like Copper CRM is great for bringing in all the communication from your Gmail, actually having that all in one place. And if you don't know, Copper CRM is the solution that we are affiliated with, and we recommend that to most small businesses. Say, for example, you're an e-commerce business or you're a product distribution type business, and doing a lot of online sales, and you want to have follow-ups, things like, you know, automated and cart follow-up sequences and those kind of things, or customer service follow-up sequences. Well, then you may err on the side of a email automation CRM. That one is going to be really more focused on high volume emails being delivered to your different customers, right? The third example would be if you're a more sales-focused organization, so like maybe you're an events company, or maybe, you know, for whatever reason, you're doing a lot of selling, you've got a large or a sophisticated sales team or an account management team or a relationship management team, and you really want to make sure that you have great reports, you can see activity, you can see forecasting, you can see pipeline, and you have everyone working through, you know, quite a rigid sales process, be looking for a CRM which is more on the side of your sales process oriented. So they're kind of like the three different kind of examples for you. The next decision that you need to make is, do you go for an all-in-one versus going for specialist software? And what I mean by this is, for most industries, you will have an all-in-one solution for your particular industry. And so in the IT industry, we call that PSA, or professional services automation. Basically an all-in-one tool that would do tickets, a little bit of deal management, probably does some invoicing, some project delivery management. Basically it's trying to be like an all-in-one solution for everything that business needs. If you're in the allied health services, you'd probably be familiar with a tool called Clinico, and that is a cloud-based, browser-based tool and solution which allows all businesses that are running an allied health practice to have all of their customers and clients and bookings and scheduling and you know, online bookings for customers and all those kind of things. If you're a gym or a yoga studio, you'd probably be using something like MindBody, right? So these tools are kind of trying to do everything for a particular business vertical. And they have the upside of doing most things pretty well, because you're going to have a lot of industry specific features that are really useful for you. Downside is they usually only do about 80% of what you want. And so they do everything, not everything really, really well, or let's say not everything best in class. What I'd say as an example is something like MindBody Online, which allows you to do online classes and bookings and lets people schedule in, or another tool for booking in if you've got like a, you know, a hair salon or beauty services or something like that. Those kind of CRM systems are usually not really sophisticated on the email marketing side of things. You need to like connect them to MailChimp. You need to use a third-party emailing service, and you can't do like sophisticated automated email follow-up sequences, because they're just not designed for that. They're mainly designed for delivering services for your particular business vertical. All-in-one solution is going to be great in that it's going to do things that are specific to your industry vertical, but it's probably not necessarily going to do everything you want to do. The second option is to go through specialist software. And what I mean by specialist software is you pick best-in-class software for each you know, area of business that you're working with. So that's the route that we typically take at IT Genius. What I mean by that is we use Copper CRM for our sales process, because that's where it really, really shines. We use it for some of our emails, but some of our more advanced email broadcasting we do through Infusionsoft, which is a email marketing focused CRM. Now, Copper are actually bringing out email marketing, so that'll be in the works. We may end up moving that at some point in the future. But then for other areas of our business, like project delivery, we currently use Asana, which is a great project delivery app. For our customer service and emails back and forward with our customers, we use a combination of live chat using Google, Google's chatbot, which is called Dialogflow. We also use a tool called Hiver, which is a shared inbox platform, which works right inside of Gmail. And we've got other videos on shared mailboxes if you check out our YouTube channel, if you're interested in that. Now, the upside is we get best-in-class project management, best-in-class email automations, best-in-class CRM system and deal tracking, best-in-class shared mailboxes and support delivery, because we've got literally tens of thousands of employees that we support across all of our clients. But the downside is interoperability between those systems. Sometimes you end up managing multiple databases, and so we need to build connections and links between those different apps so that they all talk to each other. So that's one of the big choices for you to make, whether you want to go for an all-in-one or specialist software. It really comes down to you choosing, you know, what are our business priorities? What do we want to have really, really nailed with our business software? And then making the decision from there.